This afternoon, we are providing an update on our investigation into the fatal shooting of 34-year-old Will Smith. The New Orleans Police Department worked this case aggressively over the past 12 hours, from immediately detaining the perpetrator on the scene last night to interviewing witnesses and processing scene evidence. Here's what we know right now. Around 11:29 p.m. yesterday, we received a call of shots fired in the area of Felicity Street and Sophie Wright Place. Our officers responded within 4 minutes. When we arrived, we located Mr. Smith partially inside of his vehicle, suffering from multiple gunshot wounds to his body. He was later pronounced dead on the scene. We also found his wife, who had been shot to the right leg. She was taken to the hospital where she was treated for non-life-threatening injuries. Based on our investigation, we learned that Mr. Smith and his wife were traveling eastbound on Sophie Wright Place in their silver Mercedes. As they were approaching Felicity Street, their vehicle was hit in the rear by an orange Hummer H2, which caused their vehicle to hit the rear of a gray Chevrolet Impala. The Impala was occupied by two acquaintances of the victims. They were not injured. At some point, the driver of the Hummer, later identified as 30-year-old Cardell Hayes, and Smith exchanged words. Shortly afterwards, Hayes produced a handgun and opened fire on Smith and his wife. No one else was injured in the gunfire. Cardell Hayes stayed on the scene until the police arrived. He was immediately detained and questioned and later brought to central lockup, where he was booked with second-degree murder. There was a passenger inside of Hayes' vehicle. He was questioned and released. At this time, we don't have any information that would lead us to believe that he was involved in this shooting. Our investigation continues as to motive of this shooting and whether or not Smith and Hayes knew each other prior to this incident. Detectives continue to work aggressively to identify any surveillance video in the area and gather additional evidence that would help this investigation. While this was an isolated incident, it is certainly tragic at every level and on all sides. One life is over and another life is ruined. Make no mistake about it, we absolutely do not tolerate this type of behavior on the streets of New Orleans, and we will build a strong case for the district attorney to prosecute Cardell Hayes to the fullest extent of the law. Our thoughts and prayers are with all families who are impacted by this terrible crime, and I also want to commend our officers who responded quickly and professionally to get this situation under control and to ensure that no one else was injured. Well, thank you, and at this time, I'll take any questions you may have.
Does it seem like, do you have any, I know you said it's under investigation, but does it seem that this was just random, or do you have reason to believe, at least early on, that Hayes knew Will Smith and targeted him in any way?
So this is still under investigation. We don't have the answer to that right now, but that's part of the investigation. At this time, we do not have any information to suggest that they knew one another or that this was anything other than an accident that turned into a dispute, disturbance that turned violent. He has not.
Has he spoken at all?
He has. Our investigators interviewed him. He has, but that's part of the ongoing investigation. But the answer to that question about whether or not they knew each other did not come out as we know right now.
The car that had Smith's friends in it, in front of him, any information on if were there any NOPD officers in that car, any former officers?
There were acquaintances of Mr. Smith and witnesses into this investigation. And so right now, I would answer that they are witnesses to this. To my knowledge, we had a former NOPD police officer who was at some point with the acquaintances, but we don't have the information that at that point that he may have been with them.
What's Hayes' mental state right now? Is he mentally competent, in your opinion? Is there any reason to believe that he could be mentally impaired or deranged or suffering from any kind of mental ailment?
So I don't know that any of us have the expertise to make that medical diagnosis. Right now, what we can say is that he was on the scene when police arrived. We took him into custody. The weapon was confiscated from the scene. He was taken to NOPD headquarters. He was interviewed. None of us have the expertise to make a medical diagnosis about his mental capacity.
Was the weapon licensed or was it a legal weapon?
That's still part of the investigation, and so that will be forthcoming.
So what was Hayes' demeanor when he was interviewed, when he was picked up? Was he calm? Was he rational?
Well, you know, the commander of special investigations and the commander of homicide were here. All of those are answers that come out in the investigation, and I would not want to answer anything that could compromise that or create possible defenses for Mr. Hayes. Right now, he remained on the scene. He was interviewed by our detectives, and that is still ongoing.
Chief, did Mr. Hayes say anything about self-defense? Did he say anything about that?
That's a question that we'd like to not provide right now any answers. What I can say is that he was interviewed by investigators from the homicide division. And so right now, we're not ready to talk about motive. We're not ready to talk about how or why this happened. What we know is that we have information that lead us to believe that he was the shooter and he was arrested and will be charged as such.
Did Hayes or any of his acquaintances in the Apollo, did any of them have a firearm?
We only confiscated one firearm from the scene.
Chief, any update on the wife?
The wife was treated for non-life-threatening conditions. I have not, as of yet, spoken to her, but I will be checking on her. To my knowledge, it was one shot to the leg.
Was there a weapon found in Mr. Smith's car?
That's part of an ongoing investigation. We confiscated a weapon that we believe was used in the shooting, and that's the only one that we, I believe, confiscated right now. Any other information would be forthcoming as part of the ongoing investigation.
How many toxicology examinations would y'all do?
I'll let the lieutenant come talk about that.
Right now, with the investigation being in its preliminary stages, actual pathological examination hasn't yet been done. The toxicology process usually takes 6 weeks, so that hasn't yet begun at this time.
Hayes has an interesting background with his father being shot and killed by NOPD officers and winning a settlement against the city. Is that, do you think that played any role, or is that just an interesting, or is that just something that happened in the past and just happened, or did it play any role in this whatsoever?
That is interesting, and we right now, we're investigating the homicide, all of those facts. Perhaps we'll ask questions about those and maybe see if there's any correlation. But right now, there's no information right now to suggest that any of that had any reason or played in any factor into this shooting.
Because is it true Officer Saravola was named in the lawsuit that was settled by the city and was at dinner with him last night?
I understand that to be a fact, but we have no information to suggest that that incident that occurred back then had anything to do with the shooting last night.
The gun that you confiscated, was that legally owned by Hayes, or was that an illegal weapon?
So we checked that, and to my knowledge, right now, it has come back with no record.
Do you know if that gun belonged to Mr. Smith or
to? Well, that's part of the investigation that we're working to ascertain the answer to that. It came back with no record, and so right now we still have to work a little further to trace it further.
And what about any charges for the wife, Raquel, being shot? Any additional charges?
That may come as part of the ongoing investigation, but right now Mr. Hayes was charged with one count of second-degree murder.
How is the cooperation level between the witnesses, Pierre Thomas, Billy Saravola, and the wife of the victim?
To our knowledge, everybody was very cooperative. We had no resistance.
Chief, any run-ins with Hayes in the past?
Not to my knowledge, sir.
Did somebody physically hold him at the scene until police arrived, or did he stay at his own accord?
To our knowledge, he stayed at his own accord, because when the first officers arrived, he was still on the scene.
Take one last question.
The second suspect in the passenger seat, you said no reason to believe he was involved. Is it a he or she that was in the car with Hayes?
It is a male, and we don't have any information to suggest that that individual had any involvement.
Okay. Are you guys searching now for surveillance video in the neighborhood, just to give you a better idea of what happened out there?
Yes, ma'am, we are. We were last night and continue to search.
That's all we got for right now. Thank you, guys.
Can you confirm that Pierre Thomas wasn't in the car?
I cannot at this time. So all I have right now is the information we told you. These are answers to questions that we know right now. And so our investigators are still working. There's still a lot more work to be done. As more information